The OPTIMA project will develop an environmentally friendly integrated pest management framework for vineyards, apple orchards and carrots, including all critical aspects of integrated disease management. It will contribute significantly to the reduction of the European agriculture's reliance on chemical PPPs, resulting in a reduced use of agrochemicals, lower residues and reduced impacts on human health. Today, we sit down with the team of Wageningen University and Research to talk about the OPTIMA project. Hello Gerrit, you are a project leader. Can you tell us about the OPTIMA project?
Yeah, the OPTIMA project is an EU-funded project. It's on integrated pest management. We are working on a holistic approach to do environmental friendly pest management. And we are working in three use case crops, in vineyards, apple orchards and carrot fields.
Mm-hmm. And what is Wageningen's role in this?
Now, we are responsible for developing the early detection system. It's an early disease detection system which detects the several diseases in the crops.
And how will it object that goal?
Well, we are developing techniques based on machine vision, using color cameras, using spectral cameras. And we apply deep learning techniques to do disease classification.
Tim, you built the hardware and software for this smart camera system, so can you tell us a little bit more about its technical details?
Here you see the early detection system. It's connected to the decision support system through the 4G antenna, which also receives the GPS signal we use for localization. We know where the camera is when it takes an image. And it's a smart camera, so it doesn't only take the images, but it also processes them. And then we have the final result, the decision in this case, is there a disease or not, which is sent up to the cloud for further processing.
Hello, Peter. The smart camera uses a deep learning algorithm and you have fine-tuned this algorithm. So how does it work?
Yeah, so we started collecting images from the three diseases in the field. And on these images, we trained a deep learning algorithm. And the deep learning algorithm is actually a object detection algorithm, basically meaning that if an image is presented to that algorithm, it can determine whether there is a disease and where it's located in the image. And with that information, we can process a task map and we can load that task map on the spot sprayer. And with the spot sprayer, we can apply the right dose of plant protection products at the right location and at the right time.
Joseph, during the project, you employed several cameras. Why is that?
Well, the smart camera relies on a traditional red, blue, green camera. This is a camera that you can buy off the shelf and it's the normal camera that you have like in your phone and things. But we also wanted to look into a different type of camera where we thought we could get better results. So we employed a spectral camera. Now a spectral camera is different because instead of just three large colors, we have lots of colors. And we go from red to purple, but we can also move outside our visual range into infrared and ultraviolet. The advantages of that is that that means that we can see things in the camera that we can't see with our naked eyes. So we can take the wavelengths of light, then those images that show the most contrast between healthy and diseased plants, and use them to make a really high contrast image to feed into the neural network. And so then, using that, we can get even higher detection rates in Alternaria and apple scabs.
So what are the results?
Well, we started in the project with controlled experiments. And there we achieved quite good results in the detection of the diseases. And then last year, we developed this early detection system. We sent it to the partners in the field, to Italy, Spain and France. They mounted it on a tractor, drove through the field at a speed of 1.5 km/h. And then the results decreased a bit.
Oh, so what did it teach you?
Well, actually, after the first acquisition of in the field trials, we again retrained the network and that improved the results quite a bit. But the other thing we detected is that specifically in the carrot and in the apple, that adding spectral information also significantly adds to the detection rate.
Thank you for giving all this information. It sounds like a very promising project and I hope that the future will be bright for this research.